Hey Riley, how's it going? Okay, so start of a new episode, start of a new way of doing things. Sorry, I'm just out in the end at the moment, collecting a bit of draconium. I've already raided the main island. All those dots you can see are torches that I placed wherever I ran my digital miner. So I've pretty well raided the thing. Can you see this thing down here on the map? That's a meteor. It's also put in by a draconic evolution. And if we go and find it, wherever it is, come on. I have decided to change things up. I mean, I've been spending a fair bit of time explaining how to do stuff. Yeah, see, there you go, meteor. So it's a little bit not quite as dense at this end, and it gets quite dense down at that end. Because it's the only solid stuff around here, you tend to get lots of Endermen. Now I do have my coin of fortune activated so that I don't lose my miner. Okay, let's try. Is it going to be worth doing here? I don't think so. Let's just run down the other end a bit and drop it here. Start. Oh joy. Why didn't it pick that up? Well, that's interesting, isn't it? That's very interesting. Why didn't it pick that stuff up? Oh well, whatever. Something to look into at another time. But you can see sort of as we get down to the denser part of the meteor, there's a lot more happening down here. Okay, so let's go home. Alright. Now I've been taking a lot of time to explain, you know, stuff that I'm doing and all that kind of thing. Which is, you know, I hope it's helped you out. However, from here, I'm just going to, like, unless there's something I really do need to explain in depth. See, look at all the draconium I got. Isn't that just lovely? If there's something that I need to explain in depth, I will. Otherwise, I'm just going to sort of move through things a fair bit faster. I'm so glad to be back playing Minecraft again. I recorded like basically everything up to the applied energistic stuff, including that, was all stuff that I recorded and, you know, didn't edit. So then all of a sudden I've had to edit, you know, I don't know how much footage and, you know, loads of videos and all that kind of stuff. And oh, it was just hard work. Alright. So I'm going to turn all this into draconium dust and, we'll go from there. Okay. Check it out, alright? This is all the draconium that I collected. Oh, I love it when things start to get ridiculous. Okay, so I've done all that. I ended up with, I've now got about 11,000 draconium dust, which is heaps. I still have 516 sitting in my ME system that, that's insane. Let's see now, what else have I been up to around here? Burn quartz with a block of coin. Yeah, you can go there. Did some work over in my power generation plant. Hang on. Okay, like I was saying, I did some work over in the power generation plant. Let's go and check that out. I've opened it up a bit more. I've been experimenting with a few build ideas. I've put that around the top like I said I was going to. Made some cryothium flux ducts. This is all factory block, which I kind of like. It's a bit dark in here in places. Okay, so here what I've done is I've run some flux duct underneath here, brought it up, and can you see there are Enduro power conduits all along here? So in order to supply power to somewhere, all I've got to do is just grab a transceiver, drop it on the floor here, and it's automatically got power. There's one thing I want to sort of push. That's it. Okay. Meh. Can't see it. Alright. So I've been thinking a bit about about what sort of place to build, you know, and I was sort of mucking around with a couple of ideas about having power here and some farmland out there where I've leveled off some trees and other stuff like that. But I've decided what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a place that you basically can't build in vanilla Minecraft, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have, ultimately, all of this will go, everything that's in my little starter cave will go to other locations. I will keep power generation here and expand it as I go. But that's all that's going to be here, alright? I'm going to use some, you know, some mod stuff to create teleport things so that, you know, basically what I've got is I've got like a central room somewhere which has got teleporters to all the parts of my house, and my house will be spread out all across the map in many, many different places. You know, so that in order to go from, say, you know, the power generation place to the Thorncraft place, you'll go to the teleporter, teleport to the, you know, the main room, and then teleport from there to Thorncraft. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to find a place to, you know, to start off with building a bit of a room for, you know, all of my teleport bits and pieces. And the thing that I'm going to use to do the teleporting is, these things. There's dislocated pedestals from Draconic Evolution. Now what they hold is an enhanced charm of dislocation, which is something that you can use to, you know, you can set a destination and you can just use that to go back there anytime you want. But if you put it in a pedestal, it will return you to, it will, yeah, you'll see how it works, but it's quite cool. And these require, you know, some draconium ingots and a wyvern core, which is, oh damn, we need to farm nether stars. Whoo. Alright, so that's going to be something, a bit of a project to get happening, I think. Yeah, that's going to be, that's going to be number one on the list. Farming nether stars. Alright. I'll get that done, and when it's finished, I'll show you what the thing to farm nether stars looks like. Okay, need some more skulls, so let's see now, this and this is going to give me an extra modifier. This and this will give me an extra modifier, and this will give me a modifier. Good. So now, be hitting 4, 5, and 6. 80% chance to cut a head off. Brilliant. Okay, so here's the idea. We've got a tank of water, power source, there is a draconic mob grinder here, and a vacuum chest, which will capture everything. So the plan is I should be able to build one of these. Uh-oh. I might have a problem here. Alright, so let's just build it on the bottom. Alright. And I can stand here. Or not. Anyway. Whatever, it's giving me my skulls. So, like I said, I want to build my house so that it's a bit more spread out and stuff like that. Basically spread out all across the map with different locations for different purposes. Mostly because you just can't, you know, you pretty much can't do that in vanilla Minecraft without a fair bit of effort. And running rail lines everywhere, which would be a complete pain. So I'm going to be using these things. I'm going to be using dislocated pedestals and the enhanced charm of dislocation. Now, just on this thing, right, if you shift right click, you get a little bit of a GUI, okay? First thing to note is fuel, all right? Fuel, it uses ender pearls at the rate of one pearl per teleport. And all you do is just click. And it adds the pearls, and down here it says out of ender pearls, got 80 fuel, no worries. To set a destination, you can add new, and it comes up with, well, that's the coordinates, but I'll call this home, and we'll commit. Good. If you have multiple locations, you can lock it so that it can't be messed with, or unlock it so that you can rename it or remove it or whatever. You can also move it up and down. If you've got multiple ones, you can hold down shift and scroll through. Like if you look down in the corner here, scroll through the different locations by holding shift and using your mouse wheel. Now I've only got the one location, so it's not doing that. Now in order to do something with the pedestal, we just put this down on the ground, put that onto the pedestal. Now you see it's set to home. All I've got to do is just right click. And it takes me back to where I was. Nice and easy, alright? Shift right click on the pedestal and it will give me back the charm of dislocation. Alright, so we'll just get rid of that. I'll be wanting that a bit later for something probably. Okay, so let's just go inside. Drop this two into here. Wonderful. Eat some steak. And here's one I set up earlier. Now you notice this one says hub. That's because I now have a place set up to be a teleportation hub. I wanted a fish tank, but there's no fish, alright? So I had to use squids. These are all named dot. Yeah, you get the idea. And there are, you know, sort of little frames so that, you know, the one that leads to the farms has got, you know, sort of an oak tree and a wheat thing, so you get the idea. What else have we got? Oh, I like this stuff. Carpet. Looks pretty cool. Muck around with it a bit. Very funky. And for lighting on the roof, see this stuff? It's liquid glowstone. Liquid glowstone floats. This place has been set up so that there's a bit of a channel here for it to hang around in. And, yeah, it's kind of interesting, very different, And then on the outside, we've got these fancy lanterns. There's a few of those. Great wood leaves for a border, bit of grass. And yeah, that's what it looks like. I've kept it, you know, I thought about making doors and things like that, but I decided I wanted this fairly open. So that's what I've done. And I've just sort of, you know, curved it down around the bottom. So let's head off to farms. And here we go. Now, this area I'm going to be using for all of my farming. I'll have a little house here for, you know, with all of my cooking bits for Pam's Harvest Craft. I'll have little gardens everywhere and other stuff like that. Basically, any kind of farming that I want to do, it's all going to be happening here. All right. Yeah, we've got some bits and pieces there. Now, today's job, I will be setting up a bit of a tree farm. You can see I've done a bit of work already, you know, setting up some pathways and a little building over there. I'll explain that and why it's off in the distance a little bit later. Okay, so here's my bits and pieces. Now, what we're going to be using for the farm is a thing called a planter and a harvester. Now, these two things work in conjunction, all right? Now, to when you put one of these things down, right, like the planter, you know, will only plant in a 3x3 area. There are range upgrades to increase the range so that my tree farm will be this area that's bordered by the brick. Same with the harvester. Harvester harvests in a 3x3 area, and it will only... yeah, you can upgrade the range, you know, so that it sort of works in conjunction with each other. Now, I'll grab this conduit facade first and plug this in here. Wonderful. Now, the planter lives one block below ground level, right? Just dig up a bit more ground. All right. And I'm pretty sure, no, the other way around. This actually is going right on there, so that its area of effect is the whole area, alright? Now I will grab an item filter and this conduit. So I've got a few bits of conduit all ready to go. And one of these tanks and one of these and both of these. Alright. So here's what happens, alright? I want to insert saplings into the bottom of the planter. Now you can see it's, you know, you've got this filter thing. Basically you can divide up the area into, you know, 3x3 sort of a thing. And you can tell it to plant different things. But I'm telling you, trying to manage that, you know, and manage the saplings and all that kind of thing, you know, it's going to be a complete pain. There's our radius increase. Now this I want to insert, I want a filter, and I want an oak sapling that I've got in the box. Good, good. That's there, and I'm going to increase the priority of that. Yeah, because I want that to be the most important thing that is on this particular network. Alright, so I'll just leave that there for the moment. Now, the harvester is going to output oak wood, it's going to output saplings, and it's going to output apples. But it's also going to output something else. So let's just put this in here so that there's a, it's nice and fast. The other thing it's going to output is something called sludge. Now you have to do something with your sludge. Here we go, sludge. Good stuff. You have to do something with the sludge because if this thing fills up with sludge, it'll stop operating. So you do need to deal with it. Now, sludge boiler. This is a little piece of Minefactory Reloaded equipment that takes some, you know, a bucket of sludge and a bit of energy, and it turns it into stuff. So we've got a 5.5% chance of getting peat, we can get ash, decaying wheat, sand, clay, dirt, gravel, red sand, got a bit of a chance of soul sand, mycelium, podzol, yeah, netherrack, all that kind of stuff, and tainted soil. So you've got a few bits and pieces that you can get out of just processing the sludge. The sludge processing I'll be setting up in that building over there, and the reason for that is because if you get anywhere near the sludge boilers when they're operating, they make you sick. Alright, so let's put a dimensional transceiver in the back here, and we want to receive general power, and we want to send to ME system, and that's on that one. The ender tank we're going to put here. Alright, this is the ender tank. This has been color-coded black, black, black. And that is for insert. That is for the sludge. Extract. Getting dark. I'm just going to quickly sleep. Alright, and we're going to need power. So we shall add some power to this. Do power, I want to insert. Yep, don't care. Item conduits. Let's just dig out the side so that I can get to the thing. Items we're going to be inserting at priority zero. So when it takes the saplings out of the harvester, and you can see that it's actually operating now, it will first of all try and put all the saplings into the planter, and when that fails, it'll put the leftover saplings and everything else into here. Okay, we've done. We've done, you know, conduits and priorities and things like that before with our rotorcraft thing. So I'm just going to quickly run some conduit along the bottom here to hook it all up. Good. And some power conduit. Yeah, lots of power. Alright, and you've got plenty of power. Okay. So that is the first part of our little setup completed. Alright, so I'm just gonna cover up what I need to cover up. And I'll do that last one in a little bit. Because I need to insert the first set of saplings sort of manually. Plenty of power, waiting, but before I actually go and put the saplings in, I want to deal with this this sludge boiler issue. You need to go here. Oh, yeah, there's a couple of additional options in here. You can tell it to take the leaves off if you want actual leaves for something, but that means you get no saplings. And this is to do with harvesting mushrooms, if you want to do it. So let's go over here and grab the last couple of our bits and pieces. Now, I want. How do I want to do this? Now that should be powered. Receive general power. Good. Some power conduits. And we'll put our two sludge boilers on the top. Yay! They've got plenty of power. They're not doing anything. And I'm going to put the end tank here. I'm going to put this ender chest out the back. And fluid conduit. We extract from here and insert into the sludge boiler. And then the item conduit. We extract from the sludge boiler. And insert into Mr. Ender Chest. Alright, so that little setup will take care of processing my sludge through the sludge boilers. Oh, by the way, for a farm this size, one sludge boiler won't do it. You need two. So this will take care of. Oh, do you like the place? It's not bad, is it? Got some carpenter's things happening with some chiseled glowstone, some geostrata here, and chiseled glass and chiseled wood. This is a chiseled door with some onyx, which I've used on the corner here. Bit of onyx up here. Slopes and other things like that to make the roof. And then for the roof itself, I used etched basalt, so I get a funky little lined pattern happening there. Okay. So that's our little setup here. That should work fine. We'll come back and check that out a little bit later on, but we should be done with that. So now, having sort of put these down where they are, cabled everything up the way that I have, I've got my sludge boiler ready to go. So I should be able to. Stick these into here. And I'll just cap it. Right. And you see it madly planting trees. Brilliant. Underneath the my little pedestal here is also a chunk loader and a magnum torch. So that's why there's no mob spawning, and I know that this place is going to operate once I. Oh, it doesn't want to plant in the middle. Oh well. Wait for it. Okay. Doesn't want to shear the stuff. All right, let's see if we can work out why. Well, I have no idea. All of a sudden, it just started working. So, whatever was going on beats me. So that is doing its thing. Says we've got a little bit of sludge in there. Let's just make sure we've done this correctly. We are inserting fluid. Extract. extracting fluid. Right. So as you can see, this farm got real busy real fast. I think it says that it's got 10 because it's just constantly pumping stuff out. Let's go and check out our sludge boilers. Ouch. Yeah, see, hunger and poison. Damn, that's mean. Right. And as you can see, it is, it's having a great time. Okay, so, yeah. Epic tree farm. Very cool. For some reason, it quite often, misses a, you know, a couple of saplings in here. But you collect so many that you don't care. Okay, and I'll have to work out what I'm doing with lights around here. Like I said, I don't want to be using, you know, torches anywhere, really. There's plenty of light over there because of the glowstone, but, yeah, anyway, I'll work out some lights and other things like that, and I'll continue to add to this place and tell you all about it when I'm, once I've got each bit up and running, and give you a look at it. Okay, so Minefactory Reloaded tree farm. Very, very awesome. Okay, so I'm just watching the ender chest where everything comes in via, and you can see that I'm collecting things like there's some apples. What else we got? Dirt and sand, they would have come from the sludge boilers. Yeah, some other bits and pieces. And I'll just wait until I actually get some oak, which would be nice. Come on. Lots of crap from the boilers, that's for sure. But if we're getting apples, it means that, there we go, there's some wood. Okay, so, yeah, you can see I'm getting lots and lots of bits and pieces. Got some soul sand. I've got a few souls here. Okay. And I've got some dedicated storage set up for oak wood, oak saplings, and apples. So that will happily proceed. That's what these are for. They're for additional storage for oak wood and saplings and all of that kind of thing. Yeah, on this this ME drive. What's the priority there? 10. Okay. So that is all working well. Oh yeah, I decided that you know, I could do with some more ingots of a few bits and pieces. So I'm just sending through using the export bus to export to this particular barrel. I'll explain how this works in a mod spotlight very shortly. It's going to be the next episode I do, a mod spotlight on Jabba barrels. But basically it's linked with this one. So I've got, you know, 1200 iron to put through the grinder. And that is just doing its thing, cooking up iron flakes and giving me iron ingots. Okay, so I'm going to call that an episode for today. Have fun, and I will. I quite like this. This is a funky idea. Yeah. So this is nice and busy, doing lots of stuff. Okay, so I will talk to you next episode, and we'll see what else we can come up with. Thanks, man.